What is up, ladies and germs? It is Caturday in the middle of the month of May, and it's a merry, merry Caturday. I'm finally going to tell you the story of George. But to understand fully the story of George, you have to hear the story of Tabitha. So way back in the 90s, early 90s, like 91 maybe earlier, maybe later, it's all been hazy. But I lived in Happy Valley. And sometimes we'd have bus fare and we'd go downtown. And one time when we were on the bus, and I was wearing a pair of purple shades. These girls got on the bus. And one of them, Tabitha, was on acid and borrowed my purple sunglasses. I think she might have actually got on the bus still wearing them. I'm not sure. It was a few decades ago. But, this little girl on acid, we're talking to me and my friends, and somebody said, "Tell me a story." I believe it was Tabitha. I said, "Tell me a story." This is on the bus. So, I started telling her the story about George. George is a cat. He's a tabby cat. I think tabby is where it is. The gray stripes, black and gray stripes. Gray tiger, you know what I mean? So, this cat, he really likes porridge. I mean, he has porridge for breakfast, he has porridge for lunch, he has porridge for dinner. Sweetened porridge for dessert after dinner. He likes porridge so much he even has stocks in porridge. That's how he remains independently wealthy. Every time the stocks in porridge start to go down, he just goes on a big porridge binge, depletes the supply, raises the demand, and keeps him in business. Gives him lots of free time to eat porridge and lounge about the house or go for a walk, which is what George decided to do one day. Finished up his bowl of porridge that he was having for brunch in the kitchen, and he hands out. Grabs his picnic basket, can opener, can of tuna, several packages of porridge, solar-powered electric kettle, packs it all in his picnic basket, heads out the front door. He's standing on the porch, he's like looking out at his yard, which is full of forget-me-nots instead of grass. Those little blue flowers, forget-me-nots. It's his whole front yard. Instead of grass, he's got these little blue flowers, forget-me-nots. And he looks out at the path, into the driveway where he has a little white picket fence. He looks down at the beach where his boat is docked. And he looks up the path to the left, where the forest is, forest trail. To the right, where downtown is. And he decides, "I'm gonna go for a walk on the trail." So, he heads out, locks his gate behind him, carrying his picnic basket and his typewriter. And then he starts walking to the park trail. And everything's all good. You know, he's walking down the trail as he has done for years and years before. Walking along the trail, it's beautiful summer day, birds are chirping.
And as he's walking along the path, he realizes that there's a tree in the middle of the path. This tree has never been there before, as far as he knows. This was a clear path. But now there's this tree that looks like it's, I mean, it's a big tree. Like it's been there for years, but he's never seen it before, blocking the path. And this tree, he doesn't know what kind it is, but it's black. Black, dark black. Like ever darker black. And as he's noticing the increasing blackness of this tree in the path, he also notices that the sky is growing a bit darker and the forest around him seems to be a bit more forested. The path is smaller. The birds are not chirping anymore. He doesn't see any butterflies around. And this tree looks closer and it looks bigger than it was before. Yeah, this tree is really, really big. And it's really black. And the forest starts to get more quiet and more black until everything is completely black.
And that's when Tabitha had to get off the bus because that was her stop for her friends, so I said, the end.
And at that point in time, it was. But it wasn't really the end of the story of George. And his walk in the park. It's longer than that. So, if you'd like to hear it, I'd like to tell you a fuller story of our favorite tabby cat, George. In the future. Not now. Well, like, subscribe, whatever the algorithm tells you to do.